up next on ATE TV, zeroing in on careers that utilize geographic information. GIS technicians collect data out in the field and then analyze that data for many different applications. The growing need for that data fuels the demand for skilled technicians in a wide range of industries.
We farm corn and soybeans. My name is Daniel Bossman, technology manager at Premier Grain, and I run all the data collection, data processing from all the equipment. We're just going to drive out here into a little open space and set an AB line and do some motor steering. Day in, day out would be fixing computer problems, getting computer data ready to go, troubleshooting all the technology equipment inside the tractors, making sure everything's working great. If I was looking to hire, I would look for an understanding of computers and how technology works, mainly the GPS, GIS stuff, so he kind of knew what he was doing when he put him in one of those tractors over there.
We have here is a John Deere 7820. We use this for corn and oats planting. We run it on global positioning satellites.
Set your A, it'll drive a little ways, like 100 feet. Set your B.
There's going to be a larger need for knowledge as to how the computers take that data and turn it into data that we can use. Without knowing how to use that software, all the data you collect in the field is probably useless. As farming operations get larger and inputs get more expensive, and it becomes more expensive to farm that acre of ground, there'll be a large opportunity for technology skills or degrees in technology.
My name's Clarice Madalena. I'm from New Mexico.
Most of the technology I use is, of course, the computer. My GIS background comes in handy mainly because of the GPS units, the GIS software. I use that a lot at work. I work for the Department of Interior, Office of Surface Mining. What I am is a GIS technician. I make maps using digital images, as well as integrating the GPS data that I get from the inspectors who go out to the coal mines. I have gone out to a coal mine to see what the inspectors actually do with their GPS units and what they're looking for. And then when they bring the GPS units back, then I download the data. If they need a map of it, then that's what I do.
My name is Mike LeBossier, and I am the Watupa Reservation Forester and Superintendent. My job here is to steward the forest. It's a real multi-use forest, and the city is attempting to manage it in a pretty modern and diverse way.
And here's the road that we came up, and this is the mansion.
What we're doing right now is GPS work to identify the historic landscape features that are here. There are stone walls, ice house ruins, cellar hole foundations. The object is to preserve this landscape, to tell the story of how this land was used in the past. And so we'll produce a map. The map will be used for interpretation purposes.
Do we have our GPS units all acquiring information?
We've always used mapping of discrete forest types and ecology using aerial photographs, topographic maps. But today, we're able to use GIS information more and more. We're managing thousands and thousands of acres. Information is vital to being efficient with our time and being efficient with the resource.
You go to the next corner.
The four corners and do the entrances after.
Yeah. I think when you're driven and motivated by the thing that you love, and technology becomes a tool that you understand will help you do it better, more effectively, more efficiently, you will embrace it.
For more information on anything you've seen today, explore our website at atetv.org. Thanks for watching.